So you can see the question. For the clipper circuit shown in the figure, the transfer characteristic is, so this is the circuit is given and four options are given. So you have to find the correct transfer function. Okay, so this is basically your circuit, and diode D1 and D2 is there, and two voltage sources, one is 12 volt and is 9 volt is there. Okay, now for our understanding, to solve this particular problem, let us assume this line as a ground line. Okay, so you can see with respect to this ground line, this is plus 12 volt, and with respect to this ground line, the potential over here is minus 9 volt, because it is positive over here and negative over here. Okay, okay, so the next step is, you can see the diode will be on, diode D1 will be on when the potential over here or the voltage over here is greater than equals to 12 volt. Okay, then only diode D1 will be on. In order to on diode D2, you can see the what is the potential over here, it is minus 9 volt with respect to ground, so the potential over here will be less than equals to minus 9 volt, then only diode D2 will be on. Okay, okay, so now let us assume that initially, let us assume the diode D1 and D2 both are off. Okay, so you can remove these connections. Okay, both are off, so you have only a voltage source VI and a resistor R and another resistor, how much, 3R. okay, so this is R and this is output V out. So what is the slope, V out by V in, that is basically your 3R divided by R plus R, means 4R, this is 3/4. Okay, right, so you can write V out is basically 3/4 V I or V in. Okay, now you can see that when the voltage over here, that means the output voltage, okay, this particular voltage for the diode D1 and D2, this voltage over here is basically the output voltage. Okay, so when the output voltage is greater than equals to 12 volt, that time D1 is on, and when the output voltage is less than equals to minus 9 volt, that time D2 will be on. Okay, so when the output voltage is 12 volt, that time what is the input voltage? So you can put 12 equals to 3/4 V in. Okay, so 3/4 is a 12 and 4/4 is a 16. So V in, VI is basically your 16 volt. So when the input voltage is 16 volt, that time diode D1 will be on. So the crucial voltage, first crucial voltage is 16 volt, right? Now, similarly, you can see when the input voltage is less than equals to minus 9 volt, so let us assume minus 9 volt, that time output voltage, okay, output voltage is less than equals to minus 9 volt, so what is the corresponding input voltage, that is 3/4 VI, so 3 is 9, so VI is basically your minus 12 volt. Okay, so when the input voltage is less than equals to minus 12 volt, that time your D2 is on. So in this side, okay, in this side D2 is on, and in this side D1 is on, right, and in between them both the diode are off, both. Okay, so in between them you have only this particular circuit. Okay, and the input output characteristic is simply linear characteristic with a slope of 3/4. So it will be a, in between this two voltage, it will be a linear characteristics. Okay, linear characteristics with a slope 3/4, means when in input voltage is your 16 volt, that time your output voltage will be 12 volt. Okay, 12 volt. And when the input voltage is minus 12 volt, and that time output voltage will be minus 9 volt. Simply from this equation you can get. Okay, now as you know, beyond this 16 volt your D1 is on, so you can directly connect these two line, because we have assumed the ideal diodes, so the 12 volt source directly go to the output. Okay, so it will have a saturation voltage, okay, of 12 volt. And for input voltage of less than 12 volt, what will happen, you can see diode D2 will be on, so that time D1 is off, so D2 is on, so you can connect these two line, means short circuit. Okay, so D2 is short, so output, at the output you can see you will have this 9 volt, okay, minus 9 volt directly at the output. So below this minus 12 volt you will have a saturation voltage of minus 9 volt. So this is basically the your transfer characteristics. Okay, so from the option you can see option A is correct. Okay, option A is correct. Okay, thank you.